to life as a cancer survivor. My name is Jelena, and in May of 2016, I was diagnosed with stage 3 rectal cancer. In today's video, I'm going to talk to you all about what it's like to get home from a major surgery, more specifically a lower anterior resection, also known as LAR surgery. For my LAR surgery, I had 12 inches of my colon and rectum removed, 17 lymph nodes removed, and I had an ileostomy created. I didn't get a port placed at that time, even though I was slated to begin intravenous chemotherapy about 6 weeks after that, because my surgeon said there was already going to be enough stress happening to my body during the surgery with everything that needed to be done. He didn't want to add to that placing a port as well. If you're unfamiliar with what a port is, it's a device. For me, it was placed in my chest, and there's a small tube that comes from that into your vein. And that is an easier way for them to give you IV chemotherapy instead of having to stab veins in your arms all the time. I'll explain the port a little bit more in an upcoming video. So my surgery was on October 21st, 2016, and I was discharged on October 25th, which fell right within that 4 to 7 day time range that my surgeon told me to anticipate being in the hospital for. My discharge instructions said that I should not do any driving while I was taking my pain medication, which I was prescribed hydrocodone acetaminophen, also known as Norco. I was supposed to do lots of walking to help prevent blood clots, so as to drink a lot of water to help prevent constipation. And let's see, what was that last one? Oh, and no heavy lifting until I was okayed by my surgeon. I was supposed to call the surgeon if I experienced any increase in pain, redness, swelling, any discharge from the wound sites, and also if I experienced a fever, nausea, or vomiting. I was also instructed to keep the surgical sites clean by just washing them with soap and water, and I wasn't supposed to apply any kind of lotions or salves to them. We stopped by the pharmacy on the way home from the hospital to pick up my pain medication because I was supposed to take it every 4 hours. And you want to take it every 4 hours for at least the first couple of days, because if you get behind on it and wait until you start hurting pretty bad before you take it, it takes more than just one dose for it to catch up and actually relieve your pain. Once I got home, I got to sit back and relax on our couch. But I realized how difficult it was to get off of our couch with ripped up abs. So that was an unfortunate thing. My parents had been staying at our house to help with taking care of Mayel while I was in the hospital, and then they were also there to take care of me once I got home. They prepared a delicious potato soup for dinner, and I wasn't super hungry, but I ate a small bowl of it and chewed very, very thoroughly because I didn't want chunks of potato or skins just gurgling out of my ileostomy later that evening. After dinner, it was about 7, and I was exhausted and ready for bed. So I went up and got ready for bed. Mayel came in and she read me a bedtime story before she went to bed, and then I tried to sleep. I was tired, but I kept waking up every few hours and had a tough time falling back asleep because I was used to sleeping on my side and I had to sleep on my back because it still felt like when I rolled to my side that all my organs were just sliding down to the bed inside of me, which made it really uncomfortable and hurt. I was never much of a back sleeper, but for at least that first week or so after surgery, I needed to learn how to sleep on my back. So, pro tip, if you're not a back sleeper already, try to get used to sleeping on your back before going into surgery, because that's gonna be really the only comfortable position you're gonna be able to lay in for at least a week. The next day was the first visit that I got from the home health nurse. And during that first visit, it was just lots of filling out paperwork, her making sure that our house was a safe environment for me, and us coming up with a schedule of when she would come in to visit. So we came up with a twice a week schedule for 2 weeks, because that's what my insurance would cover. Her next visit would be 2 days later on a Friday, and in that visit, she was going to help me with my first ileostomy bag change at home. I wasn't very hungry and wasn't eating a whole lot after I got home, but I had lost a decent amount of weight after surgery, so I needed to increase my protein intake to help my body recover. So we decided that we should probably look into getting like some powdered protein shakes for me to drink. Those could help supply me with the protein and the calories that I needed, and we have a bit more nutritional value than just some high calorie foods like ice cream or milkshakes. My dad drove me to the grocery store, and once we got there, I walked very gingerly and slowly up to the store, and as soon as we got inside, I grabbed one of the motorized shopping carts because I wasn't gonna make it much further walking. I was exhausted already. I was ready, if anybody questioned me or gave me a funny look, to flash my scars, but nobody did, so I didn't have to flash anybody at the grocery store. I hate the taste of fake sugars, so trying to find a protein shake that didn't have some kind of fake or weird sugar in it was pretty time consuming. I did manage to find about a half dozen or so of the individual serving pouches of different flavors and different brands for me to take home to try. That evening, I took my first shower at home. I made sure to not make the same mistake I did at the hospital, and I didn't take a super long or super hot shower. When I got out of the shower and was drying myself off, I freaked out at what I saw. When I looked down, one of my labia was swollen to about 3 times the size of the other one. It was after 5 p.m., so when I called the surgeon's office, it was just an answering service, and I left my name and number, and they said the on-call surgeon would call me back right away. So the on-call surgeon was a woman that night, which I was kind of thankful for. So when I told her what I had discovered, she was like, "Oh yeah, that's normal, don't worry about it." That would have been nice to know before I left the hospital and freaked out. So once she said that it was okay, then I spent some time trying to look up on the internet and see what exactly was going on. And it said anytime that you have multiple lymph nodes removed, well, they're not doing that job of getting the lymphatic fluid out anymore, and others are overworking or whatever. So areas nearby where lymph nodes had been removed can swell after surgery. That would have been a nice thing to know before I went home and discovered this major swelling in my lady parts. But luckily, within about 2 days or so, the swelling went down and everything was about back to normal looking. 2 days later, when the home health nurse came, it was time for me to do a bag change, but this time I needed to do it on my own. Most of it I could do, but the part I struggled with was getting the bag itself to click to the wafer that was adhered to me. My ab muscles were so wrecked that I couldn't flex them to give a stiff surface to push and click on, so it was like trying to snap things together like on top of a squishy pillow. Even the nurse was having troubles trying to get the bag to click onto the wafer. I'll tell you a little bit more of all the trials and tribulations of bag changing and ileostomy in a future video where I'll focus just on what it was like having an ileostomy. So for now, I'll just leave it at, it was rough those first couple of weeks changing the bags. The home health nurse came twice a week for 2 weeks, and then I was left on my own to do the bag changes. A little over a week after my surgery, and my staples were getting pretty uncomfortable already. I know, who would have guessed? If you take a look at this picture, you can kind of see what I'm talking about. As my wounds started healing, it looks like the skin is stretching, and the staples on the one side are tearing through the skin. But my stomach was actually flattening out because the swelling was going down from the surgery, and I wasn't eating a whole lot, so I wasn't gaining any weight, so I'm not sure why it seemed like it was stretching there. But it happened. And it was gonna be a long 2 more weeks before those staples got removed. 14 days after my surgery, I went in for an appointment with my oncologist for him to go over the pathology reports from my surgery with me. He said that the chemo and radiation that I did over the summer had shrank my tumor, but it didn't disappear completely. They did, however, manage to get clear margins when they removed the tumor, which means that they took out enough on either side that there were no cancerous cells at the ends of the section that they cut out. They also, he said that of the 17 lymph nodes that were removed, 5 of them still showed signs of cancer in them. So he said, that means I would definitely be doing adjuvant chemotherapy, which just means chemotherapy after your initial treatment. There was still a little bit of a question as to whether or not I would have to do it after surgery, but all signs before I went in were pointing to I was going to have to do it because I was young when I was diagnosed and they just wanted to make sure that this cancer didn't come back. I was bummed that the radiation chemotherapy that I had done over the summer didn't completely get rid of the tumor, but I was glad that they were able to remove it all in surgery. I was also bummed at the idea of having to do 8 rounds of IV chemotherapy that were most likely going to be much rougher than the oral chemo I did. Since my surgeon was going to be placing the port, my oncologist just sent in a request to him. So then when I went in the following week to my surgeon for my follow-up appointment, when I was there, I would schedule the appointment to get my port placed while I was at the surgeon's appointment. Having my parents stay with us for 2 weeks after my surgery was a huge help. They cooked, they cleaned, they took care of Mayelle and kept her entertained, and they took care of me. It was wonderful having my parents there to take care of me, but the circumstances around it sucked. Finally, I got to go in for my follow-up appointment with my surgeon. I couldn't wait to get the staples out. I felt a constant tugging and pulling of my skin stretched between two ends of the staples in a lot of spots. So first the surgeon came in and looked and said all of the incision sites were healing well and everything was looking great. I asked the surgeon how long I needed to wait until I was allowed to start running again, and he said 4 to 6 weeks, but I was allowed to walk as much before that 4 to 6 weeks hit. I was really hoping to run in our local Thanksgiving Day turkey trot that year, and it fell exactly 5 weeks after my surgery. So I was gonna do as much walking as I could, and then at the 4 week mark, I was gonna start jogging so that I could at least, you know, jog maybe a mile or so during that 5K or 3.1 miles. So to remove the staples, they use this special device here, and they use it and they clamp it down on the staple. It pushes down in the middle, which releases the ends. So it doesn't quite do it like that. I guess if the staple is like this, it kind of just brings the ends up. I thought it would be painful getting them out, but it was actually a sweet release. Then I asked if I could take the staples home with me, but they would not let me. So I asked if I could take a picture instead. So here's all the staples that they removed. I was so much more comfortable immediately after getting those taken out. And then after the staples were taken out, they put these Steri-Strips over just the large incision down the middle of my abdomen, and I was supposed to wear those until they fell off. Now I had 3 more weeks to heal before I had to go in for my chemotherapy training class and get my port placed. So for those next 3 weeks, I was focused on getting as much rest as I could and on making sure that I got in my daily exercise. Recovery was a little more difficult than I thought it was going to be, but I was making progress, so I was satisfied. If you liked this video, please click the like button down here so that I know you've enjoyed it, and so YouTube will show it to more people. And also make sure that you're subscribed so you'll be notified when all my new videos are posted. Thanks for watching.